If you're like me and have a potentially marriage-destroying addiction to buying cameras, maybe the Osmo Pocket 3 is the one camera that you can use to do just about everything. So I've been testing it out to try to figure out the best settings as an indoor studio camera. It definitely has some limitations. Obviously, it's got a fixed lens that is pretty wide, so it might not be suitable in all instances. It would be really great if at some point somebody makes a lens adapter that could have a narrower field of view. Anyway, I want to give you the tips about how to best set up and optimize the camera for this use case. One of the other limitations is not only is it a fixed lens in terms of the field of view, but it's also fixed in terms of the aperture. So you don't have any control over the depth of field with the aperture. The only way that you can change the depth of field is by changing the distance of the subject relative to the lens. So if you get closer to the lens, then you should get more shallow depth of field in the background. And if you get further away, then you'll have a deeper depth of field. So for this test, again, that's why I wanted to set up relatively close to the camera. And I'm gonna have a different setup where I'm more like 4 feet away from the front of the lens. A downside of being this close to the camera is that being such a wide angle field of view, it does have some distortion. And if you have a big nose like I do, you might not want to accentuate that feature, which is something that you'll have on a wide angle lens. So I want to give you an idea of what the distortion is like when you're sitting about an arm's length away from the camera. For this shot, I am in manual exposure. I've set my shutter to 1/50th because I'm shooting in 4K 24 frames per second. So I have the shutter roughly double the frame rate. I have the ISO set to 50. I set the white balance to auto so that I could see where it wanted to be. And then I switched it over to manual and then matched it. Because I have the window in the shot, I don't want the white balance to change because of whatever's going on out there. So that's why I used auto white balance to find what it was reading currently and then switch it into manual. The color profile is set to normal. I've done some testing with D-Log-M and also the HLG profile in the studio, and I find that the normal is the best. HLG looks weird. D-Log, there's really not a good way that I found to convert it to Rec. 709 that looks any better than what you'll get in normal. In studio, I found that normal just looks the best and it's also easier. I have the in-camera sharpening reduced all the way down to -2. This lens or this camera is already extremely sharp. Adding any sharpening to it in camera is just gonna make it look way too sharp. If you're getting older like I am, you definitely don't want the camera to be adding any sharpening. I also have the noise reduction in camera set to -2. I already mentioned that I have the ISO set to 50, so we shouldn't be getting much noise, if any, from the camera. If you cannot get the ISO based on your lighting conditions at or below 100, you're probably gonna want to add in some noise reduction into the camera. And lastly, I have an ND filter on the front of the lens so that I could control the exposure of the window without using my shutter speed to do so. If you have a relatively static shot like this, then you could use the shutter speed to control your exposure, but if you are a stickler and you want to follow the rules, then you can use an ND, and that way you can leave your shutter around 1/50th. I am using the Freewell filters that come in this massive pack of filters. I think there's, let's see, 7 NDs, and then there's 5 NDs with circular polarizers. So I'm using the ND8 with the circular polarizer. The circular polarizer is going to help increase the saturation of the sky in this shot. So that's why I use that. I think this looks pretty good, but what happens if you don't have as much lighting as I have? Because I have a 650 watt key light maxed out right now in order to get this exposure. So I'm gonna put the camera in auto and then we can compare what the camera would do versus what you can do if you have enough equipment. This is the extreme example. So I just turned off the key light, I removed the ND filter, and I changed from manual into auto exposure settings just to see what the camera would do. Right now the meter is reading 0, so even though the window is insanely bright, it's still somehow metering out the rest of the scene to 0. It has left the shutter at 1/50th because it definitely needs that, and it has increased the ISO. It's actually moving around a lot, so it's around 1100, between 11 and 1200. So we went from an ISO of 50 all the way up to between 11 and 1200. And without the noise reduction, you can definitely see how much noise can be introduced into this camera. Okay, so now I've changed the in-camera noise reduction to 0. So you can compare what this looked like with -2 and now with 0 noise reduction. So this is an extreme example with absolutely no light in here besides the window light, and I've got a tube light over there just to sort of light up that side, which I probably don't need anymore. No camera is really going to excel in this scenario. So I'm going to start adding in some more light, just not 650 watts worth of light. Now the light is at about 33% brightness. The ISO is bouncing around 100, 120. So this will be a lot cleaner. And now I'm going to turn off the noise reduction again. So now the noise reduction is set to -2 at the ISO that we're currently at. Now it's all the way up to 160. You can see what it's looking like. Like I mentioned, I wanted to move the camera further away, so now I'm about 4 feet away from the camera, so it shouldn't have any distortion on my features, but you can obviously see that we have a much deeper depth of field. I'm back into manual, and I've set the shutter to 1/50th, the ISO is down to 50. It's giving me about negative 0.3 to 0.7 on the meter in terms of the exposure, and I also have sharpness and noise reduction down to -2. My biggest advice for this camera is whether you're in manual or in auto exposure settings, you definitely want to make sure that you are not overexposing this camera at all. I mean, it's okay to have some things in the shot that are overexposed, like maybe these tube lights here. The window could have a little bit of a hot spot or something. But the thing that you absolutely do not want to overexpose is your skin. Because anything that's overexposing this camera, there's really no saving it. You don't have a lot of room to bring any of that back. If you have hot spots on your skin, it's gonna make it look cheap and just not pleasing looking. So that would be the one thing that you definitely wanna make sure that you avoid with this camera. You can set an exposure level or a preferred exposure level even if you're in auto exposure. So I would keep that at 0.
When you're recording on this camera, if you slide from the right, you do get an EV slider. So you can adjust the exposure compensation during a recording by sliding on this little dial.
But if you're noticing that might even look too bright, the camera has a tendency to sort of overexpose, in my opinion. So you can even go down to -7.7 or maybe even -1 and still have a good exposure overall.
Unfortunately, what's weird is that on the screen, you don't get much of an indication of your overall exposure. Of course, you can put histograms on here, but if you use the app, it has an exposure index reading right on the screen.
Another thing to be mindful of with this camera is it doesn't have any lens hood, obviously, and it's very susceptible to flaring. I have my key light actually a little bit, well, it's kind of exactly to the side of me, and you can probably see it blooming a little bit here in the corner, even though it's not really pointed at the lens, but this lens is very susceptible to flaring. You have to be careful with lights that are shining at the camera. If I actually, see if I can, yep, see that? Yep, there we go. So now I'm gonna go into auto settings so that we can compare what this shot looks like when you have as much control as possible versus when you might not. Now that I'm in auto settings, we still have an exposure meter reading of 0. But the shutter is now at 1/100th and the ISO is up to 510, 520. As a result, I turned the noise reduction back up to 0 for this shot. I think you should be able to see an overall difference in the sharpness and the clarity between the shot that was manually exposed versus the shot that you're currently looking at auto exposed. The noise reduction definitely is going to make the image a little bit mushier, a little blurrier. The two big takeaways, I think, are make sure that you do not overexpose, and absolutely make sure that you do not overexpose your skin tones. Number two thing is keep the ISO as low as you can, because even at relatively low ISOs, you will start getting considerable noise in the camera. And if you have the internal noise reduction turned on, the image is noticeably deteriorated versus when it's not on. Anyway, I hope that was helpful. If you have any other tips, suggestions about how to expose this camera, how to use it in this environment, please let us know in the comments. As always, appreciate you watching the video, and maybe I'll see you in another one.